Hi everyone. So I'd recorded a couple of videos, one of which was a room tour and the other of which was a video talking about books about pandemics and why I like to read them even while things are going on, the comfort I find in them. And I will edit those at some point, as well as making lots of other videos, I hope. Lots of you have shared things that you'd like to see in response to a tweet I did on Twitter, but also please do let me know in comments things you'd like to see. But I felt a bit, not disingenuous, I just more felt like when I sat down to edit them, I couldn't. And that's because I've been in this headspace where my head has had so many ideas for projects and things, but no ability to execute them. And that feeling is sort of familiar to me in a way. It's a depressive feeling that I have. Not so much the idea creation, but just like the executive function, misfunctioning portion of sitting in front of what you know is a task that will not take very long and just being completely incapable of doing it, and feeling so much weight on that one task. I've been thinking about over the past couple of weeks, as the COVID-19 situation has kind of really escalated here in the UK, and in Europe in general, I've been thinking about that place of like really prolific idea creation and how we respond to this moment that we're in and how I've seen people responding to it. So I'm just pausing as much as I need to. I'm realizing I need a lot of pauses. There's an impulse to just keep going and keep talking and rush through it. And I actually filmed this video yesterday and I tried to, and I went to watch the footage back and I'm just like, it's all between breaths. It's like these anxiously caught words. And I didn't even feel anxiety when I was filming it, but I could hear the lack of breath in it. So a moment for a breath. And then let's do two more. Okay, now we've all breathed a little. Breathing room, that's what it is. It's been interesting to see a lot of people have that impulse to start projects and start new things and live stream and just really do things that make them feel connected and present. I was having a lot of that impulse. I was having these ideas. I was frustrated with myself for not being able to start them. And then I sort of paused and said, no, there's a very big shock happening. This thing that has not happened in our lifetimes and has not happened for many tens and tens of years is happening. We don't have all the information. The unknown is scary. I like control. I tend to feel safest when I feel a sense of control. And right now there is a lot that is out of my control. So it makes sense that I would feel nervous and that I would feel a bit unsteady. I know it's not all been that. It's been ups and downs and waves and some days of like feeling really good to go and other days of feeling so overwhelmed by it. So it's all sorts of different things. But the way I need to respond to that, I'm not going to say this is the way everyone needs to respond to that, but the way I need to respond to that is by slowing down, taking things one step at a time, 1 minute at a time, 130 seconds at a time even, and allowing myself to feel the fear, the uncertainty, the worry. Also feel the tiredness. I'm not sleeping very well, as I'm sure a lot of you aren't. Or feel the joy that comes with a rush of energy from an unexpected place. Or, you know, an expected place. I went to the supermarket the other day and arrived right after there'd been a delivery, and I felt such this rush of pure joy that came from being wealthy in asparagus. Like, I was so happy to find asparagus. Things like that, just allowing myself to feel whatever I'm feeling is so vital. And in a lot of ways, I realized, I feel like I've been training for this, or preparing for this, for the past couple of years, and of course, for my entire life. Because I, as you all know, 100% of you, am a perfectionist, and I put really high expectations on myself. I have for a long, long time. And I have a tendency to, in whatever way, kind of punish myself if I don't live up to these expectations that are really unrealistic, really too high, because it's just an easy way to sort of use yourself as a punching bag. It's an easy way, sorry. Remember to hydrate.
Ooh, it came out squeaky.
It's an easy way to redirect things that I should be feeling in a healthy way towards myself and saying that I feel this way because it's my fault, everything is my fault. It's not something unique to me. A lot of people experience this. I mention it, not just to like tell you all about my personal life, but I mention it because I responded to this initially with the same kind of pattern that I did in my life kind of to this day. I set myself sort of unrealistic expectations for how I should be coping. I explained away my feelings and I dismissed them to a certain extent. I didn't do it as much as I used to, but I did it still to a certain extent. Like for instance, I know a lot of people and probably a lot of you have lost their jobs or are uncertain about their homes. And so if I was having a tough moment, I would then get annoyed at myself because I'd say, well, my work setup hasn't changed. I work remotely. I had just renewed my lease like 3 days before all of this kicked off. There was a moment of like, I'm not allowed to feel this, but you are. You're allowed to feel whatever you're feeling right now. And I encourage you to talk to friends about it. I encourage you to write about it if that's helpful for you, or record a voice note about it. But yeah, it's all those feelings of like frustration with myself and feeling like I'm not allowed to feel what I'm feeling, giving myself reasons why I'm not allowed to feel what I'm feeling. And that's sometimes because it's a feeling I can't control. It's a feeling that's uncontained. It's like spilling over the edges. And I don't like things that spill over the edges. I like things to be contained. I like things to be comprehensible and also, like, we talk about manageable, but I also think about, like, controllable, because I understand this box. I know what's in it. I had just had a mental image of my friend Jack and Dean's video about emotional baggage, and just like taking the stuff out of the bag, let it be uncontained. And that's a lot of what my diary has become as well. Like it's whatever I'm thinking that day. It doesn't have to be structured, and it's never been structured, but it's giving myself permission for that. It was opening my diary up, which happened last week. I opened my diary up for the first time in a couple of weeks, and the previous entry was about this like absolutely wonderful day I'd had at Hampstead Heath, and it was just like such a good day. And I felt like I had to sit down and update my diary and be like, all right, this is what's been going on since. And I didn't have to. I could just write what I wanted that day. It's putting in this rigidity in my life that doesn't need to be there. I say all this because I do have lots of ideas. I do have lots of things I really want to do. I do have an ideal setup for it, really. And I'm excited about that. And I want to get into a daily exercise routine at home. And I want to have fun with cooking and try cooking things that I haven't before. I want to have like themed days where I just dress up and stay inside. I want to learn new plats. I want to make videos with Sana. I want to talk to you about books. I want to talk to you about all the books that are around me, and the ones that I've been dying to talk about for ages. I want to make videos that are very light and comfortable and warming. I also want to make videos that are honest about what I'm thinking and feeling about. There's a lot I want to do, but there's time. Time has been moving very strangely. I've seen a lot of people say that, and I think it's very true. Time has been moving so strangely, and the thing I can most closely connect it with is how time operates after you lose someone who's really close to you, like that strange non-existence of it, or any other kind of really big thing that happens to you in life. Time just kind of seems to morph, and like wibbly-wobbly timey-wimey becomes this sinister sort of thing, or it can feel sinister. I think, again, if you don't let yourself just be in it, or try to be in it, try to connect with it. I can also talk about, you know, different ways I've managed to do that over time. But there is time. What I hear in myself when I say, I'm going to do this and this and this and this and this, and sometimes what I hear in other people is, I'm fine. Everything's fine. I've got this under control. Don't worry. I have a plan, which is my trademark way of coping with things. But I'm really proud of myself because in the last couple of years, particularly, especially working with my current therapist and also with the support of friends, I've been able to say, okay, I feel all right today. This is worrying me. This is something I'm excited about. Or I'm not having a good day. Or I'm not really sure how I'm feeling yet. Well, I'll let you know in a bit. It doesn't have to be this like wall thing, you know, letting down that wall and doing whatever it takes. I think a lot of people will be giving advice for how to manage this time, but the truth is none of us have been here before, really. Like, this is new to us. We're all going to bring together different parts of our experiences that feel like they are analogous to this or have something to learn from each other from this. And I think that that's a really positive thing. Just don't feel like you're falling short by not doing something that someone else is saying. By that very example, yes, I did get up and I had a shower today and I put on makeup. But then I changed into a fresh pair of pajamas. So don't feel like you have to toss your pajamas aside in favour of full business wear if you don't want to. We're all navigating this strange thing and every single day is going to be different for all of us. That's where I'm starting. I'll see you very soon. I can say that with a little more confidence than I used to. I'll see you very soon. All right. Take care of yourselves. Please stay at home. Please stay at home and take care of each other. All right. Lots of love. Goodbye.